Hi Taurus, it's Sloane Rhodes here with your April 2016 general reading. I'm going to be drawing three cards from the Fairy Tarot by Doreen Virtue and Radleigh Valentine. And then I'll be getting some clarifying cards from the Magical Fairies Oracle deck as well as the Numerology deck. And I've already shuffled all the decks and I'm ready to get started. Unity card. Wanted to jump right out. We'll take that. I'll set it aside. 2016 general reading. All right, here we go. Five of winter, three of autumn, prince of winter. Okay. Taurus, give me 1 second. I'm just going to take this in for you. All right, so it looks like Taurus, for the month of April 2016, there is a lot of change energy happening within the month, and it may have already started in the month of March for you. So let's just draw, I'm going to explain the cards to you and in the order that I drew them, but they are kind of roughly representing the beginning, middle, and end of the month. And so the first card I drew was the Five of Winter, and this card... For you, Taurus, I really feel as if you're something's just not right anymore with your friend group. This is what it feels like to me. It feels like your friends either disappointed you or you feel a certain amount of betrayal with your friends. But it's almost like you had this sudden epiphany and there's kind of the beginning of a change in your social circle, and you're no longer wanting to associate with a certain kind of person within your social circle, and this is creating some tension, not only within the group, but within yourself as well. You may feel a little bit of guilt about this, you may be kind of conflicted about this, but with that winter energy, the decision is made. It's kind of, I just see this, all this, this crystalline energy around this fairy's head, which means it's very, there's a certain clarity that kind of just hits you. It's kind of like that epiphany energy, and there's really no going back once that happens. So I really do see this tremendous shift in your, it feels like a social circle, like a friendship circle, and but there is a split there. So that is happening kind of, I see it kind of in the beginning of the month. And I see you working hard at creating something at work. You're really focused in on work or school. But it's really where your energies are, and you are being recognized for the work that you're doing. And that may be, it may just be that you're heading in a different direction than your social circle. Or maybe your success and the things you're focusing on aren't really in alignment with your social circle. But you're very, very focused on this. And this is really kind of representing the middle of the month, but this is going to pay off. And then what I see here with the Prince of Winter energy is that there is something that occurs that is asking you to make a very quick decision. This is an energy that comes in that feels very clear. There's a lot of clarity. There is the sense of immediacy, an absolute sort of truth that comes in that can't be overlooked. And with this energy, is going to feel very fast moving. It's a little exciting, but a little bit it's definitely unexpected. So I'm going to draw some clarifying cards for this, but I do want to mention the Unity card, which kind of popped out of the deck and wanted to be a part of the reading. And for you, Taurus, this really does show and a desire for more school. For me, I see this going with this, and this really. It's again, we have this sort of change. You know, five. We have this kind of change energy, but with the Unity card, it is a major arcana card, and it really is calling you to something. Something more fulfilling, either spiritually or with education. So this, I did mention school with this card, and so it could be that this thing that you're working on is really pushing you in the direction of going back to school or graduate school or college or something like that, an institution of sorts that you're really kind of focused on you're building something. You're building something for yourself, Taurus, and I really see that you want to have some financial stability from this thing that you're developing, and it's leaving. Part of this focus is causing you to kind of this changing your social circle. It could be that you're going to school. You know, these do feel very much in alignment together. I do want to draw a couple more cards on this Prince of Winter energy. Actually, I'm going to draw it on the Five of Winter, just to get some clarifying energy on this. The text of this card reads, walk away from dishonest associations, realizing that what you thought you wanted isn't the best choice for your happiness, and something that's not worth the effort. But for me, what it really does show is a split within your social circle, and you having this kind of epiphany that, you know, it's just not working for you anymore. But let's just see what the cards have to say. You, Taurus. All right. So for this Five of Winter energy, we have the Princess of Spring. We have another Princess of Winter. And the King of Winter, which is very... okay, well, let me back it up. So I did say that I felt like this was... a split in your social circle, and with the Princess of Spring energy, it is calling on you to go after your dreams. And so it kind of feels like that with that Five of Winter energy, you're leaving behind something that felt kind of stagnant, and this is very fresh, this is very bright, this is very fun, and this is calling you to work really hard. You know, you're full of passion with this, and there's a message coming about your career, about your passions, about your creativity, and it's just allowing yourself to be free, to free yourself, really, to free yourself from this and go after your dreams, which is really, really nice. And then we have the Princess of Winter energy, and this energy is, again, very much about clarity, about understanding your truth, understanding what you need and want, and this energy can come through as being not always... the softest touch, but very clear. And so even though you might receive some news that, I feel news coming in with this card that is very clear, although it may not, it may hit you a little bit more painfully because it's so clear, there's not like a softness to it, but I think you'll welcome this truth from this. And with the King of Energy also is clarifying this Five of Winter energy. And we do have quite a bit of winter energy with this. So for you, Taurus, it is all about truth and clarity. And this card really does represent absolute, you know, the King of Clarity, the King of Logic, the King of Truth. And this energy is very much with that Five of Winter energy. So it's just you getting clear on what it is you want and being just making decisions based on your truth, really. All right, let me get, I think from the Prince of Winter energy we have here at the end, I want to just, this fast-moving, unexpected changes. I think I'm going to draw from the Fairy Oracle deck just to get some information on this one. Prince of Winter for Taurus. Oh, interesting. So with this Prince of Winter energy, this is very unexpected changes. and very fast moving energy. And we have the autumn energy that comes in, which for me shows that something that you've been working on, this three of autumn, is bringing in something very quickly. You're reaping the rewards of that work. And keep yourself in a positive state, because it looks like you are being asked to take a trip. And that may be what's coming in with this, an unexpected offer. That could be, because I did say these feel like messages. It could be a message coming in. This, whatever this is, it looks like it's going to involve you taking a trip. And this even feels like you're going somewhere with this energy. So I'll read the text of this card. It says, travel, an upcoming trip proves to be life-changing in positive ways. So I see that you're working really hard, kind of nose to the grindstone. And it could be that you're going away to school. I mean, these do feel very kind of connected in terms of their color. But again, keep your thoughts positive, because there will be that tendency. You know, whenever there's change, it can be very difficult for many people. And Taurus, you are an earth sign, and you like things to be a certain way. Sometimes the air signs have an easier time with change. And the earth, this is a general reading, of course, and a general statement. But as a Taurus, you know, you can be a bit more hesitant to change, and you like your traditions, and this fast-moving energy is kind of encouraging you to make a decision quickly. And so keep your vibration high, keep your, you know, your thoughts positive, say your affirmations, say your prayers, but you are reaping the rewards of this hard work. So it could be acceptance into a school, or and you're traveling, taking a trip to look at those schools. But it feels like very, very positive energy. And the changes that are prevalent in the month of April for you are going to be very positive. I don't see anything negative necessarily with this. I mean, I never really actually see this card as being negative. It can be difficult, but I happen to love change. I think change is such an important part of life. And I don't see five energy as necessarily being difficult. So, but you may experience it differently. I don't know, but depends on everyone. Everyone's different. But in general, this looks like a very positive reading for you, Taurus. It looks like all your hard work is being rewarded, and you're really focused in on the work that you need to do to create that stability for yourself in your life. I'm going to draw one more card from the numerology deck, just to get a bit more insight. Forgiveness. So this may have to do with this. I mean, these feel like they go very, very nicely together. Whatever happened here, and it goes kind of with these affirmations, you know, it's important to keep your thoughts positive, to, you know, to say your prayers if you pray, or to say your affirmations, because when things change, maybe you were hurt, something happened, but these go very, very, these go together. In fact, 9 plus 6 is 15, it's 555, it's all very connected to the change, this tremendous change energy within your, it feels like your social circle. So, you know, be forgiving towards your friends or your social circle or towards yourself, because change is an important part of life. And I don't think anyone ever intentionally means to hurt you. A lot of times when we hurt someone, it's because we're hurting ourselves. So be forgiving, be compassionate, and know that change is very important. And this change is all leading towards really, really wonderful, wonderful opportunities for travel and school, and just more security within your own life. So anyway, that is your reading for April 2016. It's a general reading, so I hope that you get some messages out of there that work for you. Again, check your rising and moon signs as well for a more complete picture. And until next time, I wish you all the best, and I'll see you on the next video, or perhaps at your private reading. Till next time, bye-bye.